Welcome to Dr. Campbell's office. Just fill that out and have a seat, and he'll be with you shortly.
Okay, thanks.
So, what are you in for?
Excuse me?
What brings a nice girl like you to a place like this?
That's a little bit of a personal question, don't you think?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not too good at the whole small talk thing.
It's all right.
Well, maybe you could help me.
What?
See, I'm continually trying to improve myself, so whenever I make a mistake or I mess up, I just try to figure out what I could have done.
I don't know. I guess you could start with the weather. It's a nice day, that type thing.
No, it's pretty lame.
You got it, Mr. Crow? I'm giving you the old standard doctor's advice. Then don't do that anymore.
Thank you. I will do my best.
You nervous?
No.
A little nervous.
Thank you for your visit, Mr. Crow.
Thank you.
See you soon. The doctor will see you now.
Hello there.
Hello.
Just hop up onto the table there and tell me what's been bothering you.
Well, doctor, I fear it's the nightmares again.
You fear them?
Well, yes, but that's not what I'm saying.
Oh, I'm sorry, what were you saying then?
That my nightmares have been acting up again.
And how are they acting?
They aren't acting like anything, but I fall asleep, and before I know it, I'm waking up screaming and crying.
Crying and screaming. Well, that won't do. With your permission, I'd like to try something a little unorthodox, if that's okay.
Anything that will stop them.
Yes, doctor?
Could you send in the next patient, please?
Of course. The doctor will see you now.
Please, come in, have a seat. I asked you two to be here because you each face a similar issue. And I thought a little group therapy might be the best way to fix the issue for the both of you. Now, I want you to explain your nightmare to each other. You start.
It all starts when I'm alone in this spooky house.
Then I hear groaning coming from the basement.
I find the stairs, and even though I don't want to, I walk down into the darkness.
The groaning, it gets louder, and I hear that rattling of chains.
And you could tell it's coming from behind this old, beat-up, paint-peeled door.
I open the door.
And some hairy, slobbering, rabid, wolf-like creature leaps out from my throat.
And that's when I wake up screaming.
You see, you're not alone in this. And remember, there's safety in numbers. Keep that in mind tonight, and I promise that you'll wake up tomorrow in a much brighter way.